By the end of this video, you're going to learn how to color grade like a pro inside CapCut. So with that being said, let us begin. So CapCut has three different forms.
What?
That's right, CapCut Mobile, which you probably know by now from all the TikTok editing templates. CapCut Online, which is the same thing, but on the browser.
Or the big daddy, CapCut Desktop.
Which has the most insane features of any free editing software.
What?
Like, look what you can do here, bruv. Look at all these presets, auto captions,
AI markers, lightning fast rotoscope,
fast
transitions. Effects.
But today we're going to be color grading. Lucky for us, CapCut has three awesome tools that allow us to do pro level color grading. Now, the key to a perfect grade is to split it up into two parts, color correction and color grading, which is why the first feature that I love about CapCut is that you're allowed to use vector scopes, which you can enable by clicking here on your player and color oscilloscope turn on. Wow! Now, if you're looking at this and thinking,
ew, what the fuck?
Relax, bro. I got you. Relax. Calm down. So there's three here. There's the waveform, the parade, and the vector scope. So the whole point of these scopes is that it allows you to accurately color your videos. You're using mathematical data to do so. I always start by looking at this waveform here. Now, what this does is it shows you light intensity level. So right at the top is super bright. So if we were to take our clip, we'll go to adjustment, we'll go to brightness and blast it out. You see everything goes up because that is going bright. And conversely, if you move it down, it goes low. So this shot here is actually from an iPhone 15 using ProRes RAW. And you can see the colors are compressed towards the center. This means that there is little contrast because a value of 200 of a difference between 0 and 200 and from 774 to 1023. So when you're ever color grading footage that looks like this, maybe S-Log2, if you don't want to use a conversion lot and you want to do it yourself, the best way to do it is by looking at this scope. So I like to have more control, so I'm going to go to curves, right? And what you want to do on the curves is create an S-curve. It's the same thing as contrast, you'll see. If I go to the brightness or the Luma one and I just click here, I make a point. And I make a point at the top and a point right at the bottom here. And I just move this up. You can see the area here starts to go up. So that's before, that's after. I want to move this highlight up just below the max, okay? Just below the max. If we look left to right, you can see that actually what's the brightest is going to be this HP tuners, which is going to be what's being indicated here. And these lights, which are indicated throughout. The car is kind of right at the center here. These are the brightest parts of the car. So what you don't want is it to get to this point here because then it's overexposed. So just below it is absolutely fine. And then the shadows, the shadow area, we lower this down a tad. And then we can mess about with this curve until we're happy with the contrast level. I move the shadows down to the just above zero. You can also add a fade by just flicking this up if you want a nice little fade and your blacks to not be 100% blacks. So some people like to go all the way out and they like to do contrast like this and, you know, like this. That's fine, you do you. There's loads of control with this one. If you want to keep it simple, you can also just, like I said, crank up the contrast. But color grading like a pro, this is what the pros like to do. And you can see we've actually added contrast to our clip without mathematically ruining the shot, because sometimes if you color grade by just looking at the screen, you might overdo it. The next thing we want to do is increase the saturation or play with the saturation depending on your shot, depending on your color profile, whatever. I like to just crank it all the way up until I'm happy with it. This shot looks pretty good. You might also need to play with the temperature depending if, you know, your shot maybe was too cool or too hot. If you look as we change the temperature, you can see that on the top graph, which is the parade, the RGB parade, you can see that blue is like much higher up, right? What you ideally want is for all the colors to be roughly neutral, unless you're going for like a warm tone or a cool tone, right? You want it to be roughly neutral, like so, and that looks great. Cool. You can see, for example, in this shot here, the colors are swinging towards the red because we have a lot of red here. So what I would do is actually, I might take this and make it more neutral. Zoom in the shot, you see this is supposed to be white and it's not really white, right? I would have to make an adjustment until I find that this point is white. And you can see they're looking a bit more neutral. It's gonna naturally shift more to red because most of the floor is red, but before and after the colors are pretty much corrected. You just want to correct the colors first. It just makes it a lot easier when it comes to actually grading. Now that I've color corrected all the shots, what I would usually do is add my LUT. So you can go to adjustment, you can go to LUTs, and I imported my Vroom Vroom LUT pack from my site. So what you can do is you can actually double click it and it will play and test the LUT on your footage. And you can see if we do that, like the LUT comes on strong, right? So what we like to do is actually we can drag the LUT in as an adjustment layer on top, which will mean that it affects all the clips below it. So now it matches it. And then we'll click on the LUT and we'll actually drop the strength to zero and then slowly increase it until we're happy with it. Like, we don't want it to be too much, like 30 to 40% is enough. Sometimes this could be a bit too much for some clips. But if you look at that before and after, it just adds a little bit of
spicy. Yeah, boy.
And maybe some a shot like this, I might want to make it a bit warmer. So now what I'll do is I'll go through all the clips and adjust the exposure or something. For example, this one, I might adjust the exposure or contrast or whatever so that the LUT looks the best. So I'm gonna just maybe add some extra contrast here, lower the highlights, etc.
So if you're ever color grading human beings and you find that this happens when you add a LUT,
what the fuck?
Then you'll be happy to know that CapCut has a really cool feature that helps you fix that.
Say you have color corrected your clip, it looks natural, and then you add your LUT and look at that. It looks like a LUT. It looks like somebody literally added a bunch of effects to the face and the colors. And so you end up, colors on the skin may look a little bit different. So what you can do, like what most people do, is they go into like a HSL,
they find this, they like try and change the hues of a certain color. Maybe they have to find the right color, the right red, and they gotta like change things up. Or they might go to color wheels, or they might go to find the right color here, and then like try and change it up.
However, what's good is that CapCut has something called skin tone protection, where if I turn it on, it reverts the skin back to normal, and so you get natural looking colors on the skin as opposed to before where they get colored. Now, it's not perfect. If it was me, if I was doing like a like an important project and things change all the time, like this might not be enough, but for just a quick color grade and edit where you don't want the skin to be affected, this works just great.
Now, once I do that, I like to do one final pass with my color grading by using the curves to add or subtract colors to my image.
So for example, in this one, I mentioned before that we get a lot of reds. You can see this is not really white and it should be white. It's more red. So what I can do is I can actually go to the midtones and I can actually slightly drop the red until this becomes white. And you can see if I do a reset before, we just lose the reds a little bit. Also, say for example, you wanted to like add some more colors to certain parts of the image. For example, you wanted to add some blues to the shadows, you can click here and you can add more blues to the shadows. You just want to reset everything else so that it doesn't get affected too much. But yeah, this kind of allows you to manipulate different areas with different colors. Or for example here, like there's quite a lot of blue, so I might want to take the blue down, maybe in the highlights, take the blue down so that it gets a bit warmer in the highlights, and then fix it because it got a bit too green with this hit. So just minor changes that I like to do with the curves. I think it just makes a whole lot of difference. Like you see, this is a bit too red and now it's a bit more neutral, etc. So cool.
Lastly, we can use filters to add vibes to the shots.
So one thing I like to add, especially when skies are overexposed, say for example in this case the sky was like super exposed like this, is I like to add the effect called soft, which kind of adds a bit of a soft haze to it. It usually will come like this, but you just turn it down and bring it up, and what it will do is kind of soften the overexposedness light from the sky and give it like a nice soft look as if it was filmed with like a pro mist filter or something. Another one you can try is actually Dream Glow, where you might have to change the color of the glow and just kind of change the amount so that's not too crazy, change the range and all. You can play with all these settings here, but it will make it look a lot dreamier, especially if you overexpose it too much. Like this is a bit crazy, I can't lie. You can add it into dark scenes, but I think it just looks like there's no reason for it to work in dark scenes because there's not a lot of light. However, it can still look a bit cinematic. There's also some retro style effects like light leaks and stuff, but you can also add grain by going up on the particle, so it looks like it was filmed on like a older camera or something. Kind of get that retro-ish kind of look. So just other effects you can add afterwards, which CapCut make it really easy to do. Much easier than in some softwares, you know what I mean? And that is how you color grade like a pro in free software. A link in the description below if you want to use CapCut. Let me know what other effects you want to see me do in the comments below. And if you want to learn how I edited this car video, then check it out right here. With that being said, I'll see you in the next video.